In the zero gravity of space, a spinning T-bar will flip direction. Now, I'm not in space, and nor are you, probably. So, I would like to be able to play with this, but I can't because I don't have zero gravity. Now, you can kind of simulate, in inverted commas, zero gravity by throwing stuff in the air, like this guy. But it's not satisfying, I feel. It doesn't last very long. It's hard to see. I want actual zero gravity, and I can't get that, so let's simulate it, like in the computer. I'm going to use Unity. Now, Unity has a built-in physics engine. So let's make a T-bar in Unity, and we'll enable physics on that by adding something called a rigid body. Let's turn off gravity, give it a spin using this script, and here's what happens. Yeah, it spins. Nothing happens. It's pretty boring. It's not really what I want to happen. The object is configured correctly in Unity in the physics engine. It has something called a inertial tensor, but we don't get this really weird effect called the Dzhanibekov effect. But if I take these equations called Euler's equations and I implement them myself, here's what happens. Yeah, we can simulate the Dzhanibekov effect on Earth in our computer. That's cool. Now, it does start getting faster and faster, which is physically incorrect. This is because we are integrating numerically. We can reduce these a bit by changing the simulation step size from 0.02 seconds to 0.001 seconds. This won't get rid of the numerical inaccuracies, but it will reduce them. So that's looking a lot more stable. So yeah, we can simulate things in zero gravity on our computer without having to go to space. And we see the same weird effects that we see in space. If you want to see more videos like this, please click like to encourage me, and see you later.